I've been playing Sea of Thieves since launch, and right now we're in what I would consider the golden age of piracy. Making a ton of gold is easier than ever. There's a few tricks that not everybody knows about. Let's talk about how to make a bunch of gold as fast as possible. I'm Narfield, and I like to help new players find their sea legs, so if this video helps you out, consider dropping it a like. First things first, if you're solo, or if you have a crew, stock up the ship. A lot of players say stock up on the way, which is great, but in my opinion, it's better to have supplies and not need them than to need supplies and not have them. Now that your ship is good to go, let's talk about voyages. You can make a decent amount of gold just running gold hoarder voyages, especially if you reroll the maps with one chest to get a map with multiple chests by just canceling the voyages you don't like in favor for one that'll give you a better payout. But that's for when you're below gold hoarder level 20. Once you get past gold hoarder level 20, ancient vault voyages become available. Grab that voyage as well as throw up a gold hoarder emissary flag. The emissary flags will give you a boost in gold and reputation value for each time the flag levels up. And you can do this by simply touching treasure that belongs to the faction that you're sailing for. In our case, we'll be looking out for treasure chests and trinkets, since we're sailing for the gold hoarders. And stop leaving trinkets on the beach. You know who you are. Okay, back to the ancient vaults. On this voyage, you'll be given a compass, and it'll lead you to an X marks the spot. And that spot will give you a piece of a map. And that map will lead you to a treasure chest that holds the key to the treasure vault. You know what? I have a whole video for ancient vaults. It'll be in the description and at the end of the video. Just make sure you collect all the treasure chests inside before the door shuts. Once you get your gold hoarder flag up to level 5, you can sell all your treasure for the max value, or you can start on your gold hoarder emissary quest and get a little bit of extra gold. Now that's a bit more of a passive way to make a bunch of money, but maybe you're the type of pirate that likes that smoke, and you like to fight, and you don't care if people know what you're up to. Here's another way to run up that gold, but this method is gonna mark you on the map. Before you leave the outpost, look up for a big red skull in the sky. If you see this event when you spawn in, throw up that Reaper's Bone emissary flag. Just keep in mind this will mark you on the map for all players to see. With this flag up, treasure is not specific to any one company, so every piece of treasure you touch and put on your ship counts towards leveling up the Reaper's Bones flag, which is perfect because the Flame Heart event, the big red skull in the sky, drops skulls, treasure chests, and supply crates. But you're gonna have to sink some ghost ships to get it. There'll be a link to ghost ships tips and tricks down in the description. After you finish the Flame Heart event, run any extra voyages you may have and collect any random treasure that you might find on islands. That should get your flag all the way up to level 5. Then you can take all the treasure to the Servant of the Flame at Reaper's Hideout in the center of the map. This emissary method is a great way to make golden reputation in any faction, but in my experience, these are the two best ways to make the most gold as fast as possible. Just don't forget about your bonus voyages for getting to level 5, and don't forget to vote down that flag when you're done. Oh, and bonus if you do all this on Golden Glory weekends, where the base value of treasure goes up anyways. Hope this video helps you make a shit ton of gold. Don't forget to drop it a like, and there's a bunch of other helpful tips and tricks on the channel, so make sure you go check that out. Take it easy. See you guys next time.